We come to honor her today, but glorify you through all things. But Margaret, we want you to be glorified. Father, the words I say that comes from my heart, that you put there a love in me that I can just share the gospel, share the compassion, and the love of a Savior, Jesus Christ. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen. Margaret has been fired up. Going down the road. It's going to take me a minute. Preacher loves his family. You were about 11 years old. From 11 years, you grow to love people. And I'm trying to get over the emotional part so I can carry on through, but so I love him, brother. But we left the funeral home. We went by Georgie Power. I guess a lot of y'all know the guy taking the hat off. We come on down. We see people pull over on the side of the road. We see sheriff's department, city police bringing us here. It is great to be part of a community. that has respect. And that just made me feel so good, because I know Margaret would have loved that. And if Margaret's here, she would say, how long are you going to preach? Joy, a son, brother, grandkid, family, a day of celebration has come in Margaret's life. Even though it don't seem like a happy time for us, but when children take that earthly breath, they move into the presence of the Lord. But we stay behind, feeling all the feelings of the world, all the flesh, all the hurting. I can look around here and see many that lost loved ones. We went through this time together. Margaret went through the time, and Troy went through the time with other people here today. And it come her time today, which is the greatest thing that happened to God. She has achieved victory in her life. Something we all as Christians seek. 11 years ago, I came to Easton Holly, and I met a lady that spoke her mind. She would tell you what was on her mind when she would talk to you. And I like people to speak what's on their minds and being wishy-washy, being truthful. And I guarantee you, Miss Margaret was always truthful to me. And George would smile and back her up sometimes, but she would let me know the time of day, one of her great attributes. And she was always open and truthful. I could trust her. Anything she said, I believed it. She said it was a bad sermon. I believed it was a good sermon. I believed it. I remember so many times, she would tell me not to go on vacation. She didn't want me to leave to go on vacation, because it seemed like every time I went on vacation, somebody get bad, sick, or even passed. She'd be in the hospital, and that's 5, 6 years ago, 7 years ago. She said, "Preacher, don't you go on vacation while I'm in the hospital." And we used to laugh about that. So whenever you go on vacation, somebody gets sick, somebody dies. So if I'm in the hospital, don't you dare leave. I'll be okay. I'll be around. And she was actually serious about it. I was in there Wednesday. She knew her time was short. She made the statement that she had always enjoyed my sermons, and coming from her, I knew that was sincere. It made me feel great to be a pastor, that maybe something the Lord gave me to speak to her and helped her. And she went on and said, I want you to do my service, you and Brother Billy. And I told her, I'd be honored to do this service. And she said, I told her, said, you know what, Margaret, I can say some good things about you. In her usual voice, she said, I hope so. And I said, I can. And when I first come to Easton Holly, this beautiful lady by the name of Margaret come up to me, and we started talking. And she was beautiful on the outside, but the things I found out about her, she was beautiful on the inside. Beauty on the outside is candy, they always say, but that beauty on the inside is what Margaret was known for. And, she let me know what she was thinking. She told me she was glad I'd come to Easton Holly, and that her husband Troy would be there if I needed anything. And I thought I needed the prayers more than anything else, and she said she'd be praying for me. She said, oh, we need her and Troy to let me know. But her words she gave me, because I knew there were truthful words, helped me to make a transition to being a pastor here at this church. I could see a lot of myself in Margaret, but sometimes I speak before I'm supposed to, you know, need to keep quiet. I can just look at Margaret sometimes and see myself in it. But all through these years, this beautiful lady would always tell me how much she appreciated me. And that means a lot to a pastor. He works all week for a sermon or does things, Margaret would say it, I knew that she meant it, and she was telling me. So that was a good point about it, and as I said, the good thing about her was she was just beautiful on the inside, and she was on the outside, and I called it. The good thing about her, always, and I'm saying good things, she would always be at church. count on her and Troy always being here. And she was faithful. She was faithful to serve. And a great point, good point. She was a Sunday school teacher, along with Brother Troy, that was instrumental in impacting a lot of young kids here that I had the opportunity to baptize. It starts off in the beginning, Sunday school teacher, and wanted to reach the kids. And then I get the great honor of baptizing. I didn't have nothing to do with your life. I was preaching the gospel, but Troy and Margaret and other Sunday school teachers would be the ones that raised up the children and prepared them for life through Christ. And I had the great honor of baptizing quite a few that Troy and Miss Margaret taught. And she was a good teacher. She would go to the schools, her and Troy, and they would share the love of Jesus Christ with the Good News Club as they went. And she played a part in seeing so many young kids start their relationship with Jesus Christ. She was a good witness for Christ. Sherry, one of our ladies that heads up the Good News Club, I've seen something she posted on the website about Margaret. She said she loved kids and wanted to make sure that kids we taught had the food and clothes they needed. She was worried about the children, not only the salvation, but worried about their home life and stuff like that. She served on the Bereva committee, and that committee she served on, someone sitting here with us right now, just like she would be, and they cooking food, preparing food for the family to eat. Her Troy was always a vital part of that. Just always served in the bereavement in the committee. And she was a good wife. A good wife. When I was speaking to her Wednesday, and we were talking about a service, she said, take care of children. She wasn't worried about her final time. She was worried about her husband more than herself. She knew she's fixing to be with the Lord. She done come to the point in her life and I don't want to do dialysis. I want to get out of pain. I want to go be with the Lord. But she said, take care of Troy. So I don't have to say something to you. You already know. She loved you very much. She was a good wife. She was a good mother. I prayed prayers. She's asked me for family members many times. And she said, pray for this and pray for that. Family, she loved you very much. And our church family is here today. She loved all of us. She was always instrumental in helping people when they come visit and speaking to them. She loved her church, and no doubt she loved the church. When we look at so many things about Margaret, we see all the goodness, good things. And she was a good lady. We can all agree on that. But more than that, she was a great child of God. I don't know if you remember, Troy or not, but Margaret became a member of Eastern All Baptist Church by baptism March the 10th, 1996. 25 years ago, she came to this church, and her decision to come here as a member does not get her into heaven today. Her decision to follow the Lord got into the presence of God. Romans 8:16-17 says this. It says, the Spirit itself beareth witness with thy spirit that we are the children of God. And verse 17 says, and if children, then heirs of God, and joint heirs of Christ, if so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together. These two scriptures of two powerful scriptures that speaks to a family and speaks to us knowing that she has suffered so much in the last few years. I missed her. She's always sitting about halfway on that side, her and Troy. And I missed her so much, but she's been through so much sickness and so much suffering. She made a decision to follow Christ. Christ brought her into his family. She becomes a family of God. She's got a great family right here, but listen, her family is much bigger than what we see here. She's in the family of God. She's an heir. She's a part of the thing. And she made that decision to follow Christ. I think about the song, and I'm not going to sing it because it would harm y'all if I tried to sing. But the words say this: oh, what a day. There'll be no sorrows there, no more burden to bear, no more sickness and no pain, no more parting over there. But forever I will be with the one who died for me. What a day, glorious day that will be. And then that chorus goes, what a day that will be, my Jesus, I shall see and look upon his face, the one that saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land, what a day, glorious day that will be. Mark went through a lot of sickness and pain, as I said, the last few years. But listen, the Word of God just told us she didn't go through that pain by herself. She went through suffering with the Lord Jesus Christ. It said, if you're heir, if you're part of my family, that we suffer with him. That he is there with us. He's there. Jesus was there through it all, even through death. He was there. I've seen so much sickness in this family, for Troy. And I see now Margaret being healed. I see now, I can just see what the Word of God tells us. I can see what's going on right now with Margaret, that she's so relieved, no more pain, no more suffering. It says in that last part of verse 17, that we may be also glorified together. I've never really looked at that verse in that way. It says, but we may be also glorified together. What he said, if you're in my family, you're joined heir with me, you're part of my family, I'm going to suffer with you, you're going to suffer with me, and we're going to glorify together. It didn't say that Margaret's going to get glorified. It said when you get to heaven, we're going to be glorified together. We're going to be worshiping together. You always worship me on earth, but now we come and you worship together. And that is so powerful when we realize that we'll be with Christ glorified. I hadn't really thought about that scripture until I started preparing for this occasion. And I think about Jesus just said, Martha, it's time for you, me and you start glorifying. It's time for you to quit being through the suffering. I've been with you. You've been through all the suffering. I've been with you. You called on me. You called out to me. And I've been through it with you, but it's time that we started glorifying together. It's time that we get in glory together. We ought to be happy about that. This evening, we might be sad, but we can let this scripture give us a little comfort. We go through this time, this precious lady is doing something we ought to all look forward to. Not death, but the glorifying of Jesus, enjoying his presence. She's taking up, Jesus made a promise that she has the Lord to be Lord of her life. Jesus made a promise. At Revelation 21:4 tells you that promise. It says that God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. There shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain. For the former things are passed away. A promise. That's not a maybe. That is a promise from God. And he does operate his promises like you and I. Revelation 21:4, what comfort it can give us. And that promise that he made to Margaret, he makes it to every one of his children. Every one of us that. When you're the one heir of Christ, the only way it comes is through Jesus, by the way, the truth, and the life, and that is having Jesus, the Lord and Savior. As I prepared this, I kept going back to the thought of what Margaret said, take care of Troy. You know, the last few weeks, I don't have to tell you, family, take care of Troy. And that is a blessing. That's what the Word of God says to do. Stand up, take care of your parents, honor your mother and your father, take care of them. And I know family's going to be taking care of Troy. And Troy, I thank you today for loving your wife unconditionally. There's a lot of things y'all been through together. And I'm sure she'll wait today. We ought to be together again. As As a believer, you know that will happen. The Word of God promises that too. Close down, I'm going to say that Margaret served the Lord in a way to see kids get taught, kids to get saved. And she wants me to tell each person her ministry and her witness and her compassion for those kids, the same compassion she had for her family or anyone else that don't know the Lord as a Savior. Margaret, right now, we want me to share the gospel and the good news of Jesus Christ, that there's an opportunity to be with her if she's saved. But if you're not saved, you don't know the Lord, you won't be. You won't enjoy Margaret's company no more. You won't enjoy the company of a Savior that loved you, died on the cross for you. If you want me to tell y'all, it's worth it all. But you want to tell her family and friends, get your life right with the Lord. Make him the Lord of your life. She passed now through the valley of the shadow of death. In other words, she didn't die. The Bible tells us we don't die. And John 11, 25 and 26, it says, in verse 25, it says, Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. In verse 26, it says, and whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believeth thou this? Margaret didn't die. That's a word that's not in the Christian vocabulary because you don't die. That verse said, believest thou this, the last part of it? I'm sure Margaret, the moment of salvation, she was asked that question. Do you believe in Jesus? Do you believe that Jesus died on the cross and he was raised again? Did you believe? And I can just see Margaret saying, yeah, Lord, I believe. I believe. What a day that will be does no longer apply to Margaret. We can get teary-eyed, we can listen to songs, all these songs we've listened to, and what a day that will be. Well, my Jesus, I shall see. She don't see that no more. She tells you, listen, bro, what a day I'm now enjoying. I don't have all that sickness and pain. Margaret, I made a promise to her. And she would ask me, she said, are you leaving us? Some reason, she always, I'd come over here and she'd think I'm leaving going to another church. I don't know if somebody's talking. Talking, Baptist can't talk, you know. And she say, are you leaving us? And she say, be truthful, you leaving? I said, no, I'm not going anywhere. But I'm telling you today, I'm glad I had the honor of serving the Lord with Martin together. And we had a great time. She made me laugh many times, and I hope I made her laugh and happy. I loved it. I'm 56. I visited Morgan quite a few times over the years in the hospital. Louisville, if y'all know. And when I was in there, in Gainesville, last time she was in Gainesville, she was pretty sick that day. But you know what she always says if I'm standing in there. If a nurse, a doctor, anybody comes in there, she says, this is my pastor. You don't know what that meant to me. She wanted each person to know this was the man of God that I served. So I want you to know I love you, family. Love you, little Margaret. This church loves you. We're going to get through it together. You need this church, you need us for anything, just let me know, and I'm going to tell the family there'll be a meal left. Troy and Morgan always did, it's going to be following up my good meal. So I'm going to just go to the fellowship hall. But God's good. He's good. We might come to a place like this and think he's not good. Why he's so mean and why he takes me? bad things happen to good people. Margaret's enjoying the presence of her Lord and Savior, something that she's been looking forward to all her life. Father, we come to you today and close. Thank you for heavenly food. Margaret was a great friend. She's my sister in Christ. I love her very much. I do ask you to be with this family. I know they'll be looking at Brother Troy and look at each other. And I just pray, Father, that Troy goes forward, that you'll help him with the sadness, the grief, the sorrows. By just loving on him, wrapping your arms around him, and letting him know everything's okay. Father, for anyone here that don't know you, Lord and Savior, maybe after the service, if they won't talk to me or this